representing the Netherlands. These singles events are the best of seven games, each game played to 11 points. Well, the XL Arena is the largest venue being used in the competitions for the London 2012 Games, made up of five different arenas which host no fewer than seven different Olympic sports. Partyka, as you can see, a left-handed. Born in Gdansk in Poland. And with the disability of having lost the bottom part of her right arm. But it will be Li Ji of the Netherlands who will serve at the start of this women's singles third round match. Li Ji, a defender, she'll chop it back. Rallies could be long. And certainly it'd be the girl from the Netherlands at the far end of the table who would be the favourite to go through here. Both of them ranked though in the world's top 100. And the competition in the ladies is now really hotting up. The 16 highest ranked players in the ITTF rankings list coming into the competition now at this third round stage. And Natalia overcoming the difficulty of serving. Each player has two serves. First to 11 points will win the game. She was 16 when she moved to the Netherlands to play table tennis. Both players keeping the ball tight. It's a big bounce. And the chop back goes long. And she was never noticed by the Chinese table tennis authorities until she defeated the then world number 31, Li Yuanhe. And the Chinese coach wanted to meet her because he was curious why he'd never heard of her. Such is the depth of table tennis talent in China that she'd moved to Europe to improve her prospects of playing internationally. Just clipped the top of the net and went long. 5'8", taller of the two by several inches. Taller and heavier, but still light on her feet. Partyka came through the second round, defeating Skov of Denmark 4-3. It was a tight game, tight match, 11-9 in the seventh. And her reward was this place in the third round, where she's doing okay in this first game, leading by 1 point. China, of course, the dominant nation in women's table tennis. They've won all six women's singles titles since table tennis became an Olympic sport back in 1988. It would be a major surprise if they don't win a seventh in London, but there are many Chinese or Chinese-born ladies representing other countries now. And this is one of them. Born in Sichuan in China. Well, it was cat and mouse in that rally. Both players keeping it tight, looking for an opportunity to attack. Long. Li Ji has been a European gold medal winner in the women's team competition for the last 4 years, representing Holland, of course. It's a bit too high. You could see the height on the return from Partyka. It bounced up, it invited the attacking shot. It just gives the Netherlands a 2-point lead here. And now her serves a chance to close out this first game. That's a good point to take against the serve. Oh, so much spin on that chopped return that Partyka has put it into the net, and that brings up game point, 10-8. The 18-year-old Li Ji to win this opening game. Game point saved. Needs to win this point. Oh, that's a bit too high. She smashed it and she's missed it. 10-10, that's two game points saved by the 23-year-old Polish girl. And now alternate serves. The first player to have an advantage of 2 points will win this opening game. Oh, Partyka doing really well from trailing 8-10. She now has game point herself. Was there to be hit, just slightly over anxious. Back to a level game, 11-11. Well, they've both had a game point, and you had a couple. And that's gone long. So, game point again to Natalia Partyka, the world's 68th ranked best female player to take this opening game against the world's 28th ranked player. Oh, it was cautious, it was defense. Neither player really wanted to attack the ball, drawing out a mistake though, and it's Natalia Partyka who's taken it. 13-11 to take the first game, and having come back from trailing 8-10, saving two game points against to finally win it herself at the second attempt.
to wtedy my wracamy, my wpuszczamy się
Oh, the two players now in conversation with their coaches. And Partyka there, getting lots of encouragement, I'm sure. 3 points in a row from 8-10 down to get level and then to take the lead. Maybe not such encouraging words for Li Ji, who's coached by Zhen Zibin of China. So this is the start then of the second game in this women's singles match between Natalia Partyka of Poland, who is serving first, having won the first game 13-11 against Li Ji of the Netherlands, the 18-year-old at the near end of the table. Going to go long. Well, certainly the loss of the lower part of her right arm, a disability, but doesn't in any way affect her ability to play table tennis at this top level. Learned how to master the serve. And that's going to go long. Li Ji was at Beijing Olympic Games in 2008, competed in the singles, finished in ninth place. Might not get as far here in London 2012. This, remember, for a place in the last 16. That's going to go long again. Slightly perplexed. Has been a silver medalist in the ITTF professional tour in the women's doubles. To the score to Poland. Eager to get on with it, eager to drive home the advantage. And the chopped return is short. Li Ji hasn't yet fathomed out how to play against this Polish opponent. Right on the line, right on the edge of the table, which caused it to kick up, bounce high. Partyka couldn't get it back. So just the 1 point separates them, the midway stage in this second game, and one of them has called a timeout. This young lady representing Holland, the Netherlands, says her hobbies are cooking and singing. Speaks Chinese, obviously, and Dutch as well now, having lived in Holland for the last couple of years. She was such a surprise to the Chinese table tennis coaches when they first came across her that they asked if she'd actually been born in the Netherlands. She had to explain that no, she'd been born in China and had moved away at the age of 16 to further her table tennis career. Time up. Just four tables in use in this main arena for the table tennis tournament here. And all of the third round women's singles matches taking place in this session. That was a brilliant rally, but in the end the mistake came from Li Ji. Attacking forehands from Partyka. Chopped defensive returns from Li Ji. And then when she spotted the opportunity, putting in an attacking shot of her own. Two serves now to come for the Polish player. Drops the first point on her serve. And that was a big smash. Caught the top of the net, which knocked it long, so it's a 3 point advantage here to Poland, who already lead by one game to love. It's going to go long. Brings up game point. And she's got four chances now to close out this second game and lead by two games to love. And that's it. 11-6. So Natalia Partyka, 23 years of age, from Poland, taking control in this women's singles third round match. Confirmation of the scores, well, it didn't appear to be quite right. Partyka leading by two games to love, 13-11, 11-6. The winner of this match, incidentally, is likely to face Fugihara of Japan in the fourth round. Fugihara involved in her own third round match tonight, but expected to win through. Fukuhara ranked at number five in this, or seeded at number five in this Olympic tournament. Li Ji of the Netherlands will serve at the start of this third game, trailing Natalia Partyka of Poland. Love two in games, it's the best of seven. Oh, it's gone long, but Partyka not giving an inch there. She stood up to the table, returning everything, just overhit that return. One more serve to come. There it is. Yeah, she needs to get a game under her belt, get a toehold in this match. Much more attacking. Maybe that's the instruction that she's come out with to play this third game. Well, there's a tremendous amount of spin on those chopped returns from the defensive player, but Partyka seems able to deal with them quite easily. She's got a good return despite the spin. Oh, that's a mistake. Clip the top of the net. Oh, overly anxious to put it away. Keeping them tight, keeping them short. But she's netted there. It's three apiece. Players, men and women, involved in the Olympic competition here in London 2012, 86 in the men's events and 86 in the women's events. Each nation is now restricted to just putting two players in the singles, men's and women's, which means that no nation can claim all three of the medals in any one event, gold, silver and bronze, as China did in Beijing. Indeed, 20 of the 24 gold medals that have been awarded in table tennis since it became an Olympic sport have been won by China. They are very, very much the dominant nation. But if anybody can mount a challenge and perhaps prevent China winning maybe even gold and silver in the women's singles here, maybe it's one of the other Chinese girls who've moved out of the country and are now representing other nations, some from Europe, some from South America, and have taken citizenship. Li Ji is one of them, but it doesn't look at this stage as if she's going to progress through to the fourth round, losing two games to love, 5-5 in the third. Disappointing to drop the points on both of her serves. It's advantage Lee, 7-5 ahead, and with the serve. Concentration that went into that serve. Couldn't get it over the net. Point goes to Lee, but Partyka was really mixing them up there, dropping some short over the net, then knocking them long. She was moving Li Ji around. In the end, it was her mistake, though, which gave the point to the player from the Netherlands. Now she needs to win both of these points on her serve. Gone long, so 2 points to make it 8-8. These are two very important serves now. It's a bit high. Another cat and mouse rally, but Lee was overly anxious. Had the chance to put that one away, but it went long. Two more points required for Partyka to lead by 3-3. Oh, just clipped the net, but it went over and dropped on the opponent's side. Rather fortuitous. Nevertheless, it gives Poland game point for a 3-0 lead. Well, hopefully in a match, those little lucky net cords cancel themselves out or equal themselves out. But it's a big point on which to win a net cord point like that. Again, dropping them short, bringing Lee in and looking for one to attack and trying to drop that one short, but just misjudged it. Game point saved. One more serve to face. Thank you. waiting for the right ball to attack. This one. Oh, that's a brilliant return. Well, they do cancel themselves out, don't they? A big slice of luck there for Lee, having lost a point to an unlucky net cord just a few moments ago. Really big hits. And that just drifted onto the edge of the table. 10-all. Alternate serves. A lead of 2 points required. And that's long cat and mouse, seeing whose nerve breaks the first. It's game point again for a lead of 3-0 for Poland. Bit high, couldn't get it back. Too much weight on the return. Eleven all. Each player has just one serve. Oh, that was right on the white line, that forehand. Looked as it might go long, but it just clipped the top of the table, and it's another game point. Just clipped the top of the table. It was there, the tabletop was wide open. Chance for the winning shot, but that's another game point that Li Ji has saved. That's three. Well, she's saved 3 game points against her. She's now going to face another, it's the fifth actually, my apology. Partyka serving for this third game. And that clipped the top of the net again. It's twice she's had an opportunity. Been denied by the net cord. And now for the first time, it's game point to Li Ji. Oh, that drops back on her own side. 14-all. This game now stretching on. That clipped the top of the net, it's gone long, so advantage to the Netherlands. 15-14. But it's the Polish girl who will serve. Oh, it's hit the top of the net and it knocked it long. Finally, they close out that third game. Li Ji back in the match, having won there 16-14. It was a marathon. And a result that will certainly lift her confidence. She's back in this women's singles third round match. Li Ji of the Netherlands against Natalia Partyka of Poland. Poland leading now by 2-1. Well, what a disappointment for the 23-year-old Polish player. She had game points to win that third game, 5 in all in a row. And then saved a game point against her, but couldn't prevent Li Ji winning that game at the second attempt, 16-14. Well, Partyka was stretched to all 7 games in her second round match against Skov of Denmark. Finally winning in the 7th, 11-9. It was a tight one. This likewise may go the distance. It's not good. First 2 points on your own serve dropped. It's going to be long. Neither player has yet won a point on her own serve in this fourth game. Lost both points on her serves at the start of this game. She's missed that one. She has competed in the World Championship. She was in 6th place in the Dutch women's team, 2012. can see sometimes the defensive play will bring the point. It looked as if Li Ji was on the back foot there, retreating from the table. Defensive chops back. It took the point. And stepping forward to attack that one. She anticipated it well. Points here in the fourth game, having trailed at one stage, two games to love against this young lady, Natalia Partyka of Poland, who will serve and in need of points here, otherwise this fourth game will have slipped away. Very quick backhand flashing across the table. That's long. Oh, must have just caught the edge of the table. Player's very quick to acknowledge that. Almost closed the gap, and the timeout called. Coach is feeling that this is perhaps a pivotal point in this match. Li Ji looking to make it level at two games all, but with just the 1 point advantage, led a few moments ago by 4 points. Clock ticking off the timeout. Players allowed to consult with their coaches and discuss tactics and be advised how to change their approach to the match. Partyka to receive, trailing 7-8, but ahead 2-1. Will be the Polish player's turn to serve. Balancing the ball in the crook of her right arm. It was a mistake, and it was a bad time to make it, because it gives game point to Li Ji, who can level everything now at 2-all. And that's missed. So from a lead of 2-love, Partyka has seen her advantage eroded, and Li Ji of the Netherlands has now made it level at 2-all. There's the scoring, 13-11 in the first, 11-6 in the second to Partyka, and then Li Ji coming back to win 16-14 in the third and then 11-7 there. It's now two games apiece. It's the best of seven. So we're going to get another two games at least here. This match will stretch into the hour and beyond. Well, this XL Arena sits within a 100-acre campus right in the heart of London's Royal Dockland, which also hosts three Docklands Light railway stations, a car park with a capacity for almost 4,000 vehicles and lots of on-site hotels, because this venue is more normally used for trade exhibitions. But now staging seven events in London 2012, table tennis among them. This is game five. It's two games all. Li Ji, representing the Netherlands, serving against Natalia Partyka of Poland. Who suddenly is making mistakes. She's claiming a touch. Oh, I think they decided it was a let, so she's going to serve again. Made to really stretch there. Again, dropped just over the net. That's the second time in this match that the Polish girl has had that advantage of the ball rolling along the top of the net and dropping down on the opponent's side to bring her the point. And Partyka maybe coming out in this fifth game, the instruction of being a bit more aggressive. Taking 3 points already. And it's now four. Still one serve to face. Players are allowed to towel down, get the sweat off the hands, sometimes the forehead during play. Sometimes a player will use that tactic to try and interrupt the flow of composure of the opponent. And she missed that. Yep, that's what you should have done. Of shadow boxing. And that's gone long, so 6-2 Poland lead in this fifth game, two games all, women's singles third round match for a place in the last 16. Oh, trying to sweep that backhanded. Seemed to fly off the edge of the bat. These bats covered with layers of rubber. Pimples in or pimples out, that affects the different spins. Highly technical and highly controlled by the ITTF. Also the adhesives which are used to hold the pieces of rubber, the glue. Marginal advantages can be gained. ITTF very strict now about what players can and can't do. That's going to go wide. It was a little bit casual. Looked as if the concentration might just have slipped. It's still advantage Poland though in this fifth game. Natalia Partyka leading by 2.75, two games all against Ligi of the Netherlands. Let. Big, strong attacking stroke. Not what we're used to seeing from Ligi, who's a defensive player. She's had the benefit of a net cord. The ball just getting over the top of the net and landing on the opponent's side. And raised an apology. Nevertheless, the point will still be welcome. Now the change of serve. Can she drive home the advantage here? The balls to attack. Yeah! It's all square. 2-2 in games, 8 apiece in the fifth. Ligi, who came back from trailing 2-0, now serving to put herself in a commanding position here in game 5. Going for the big hit, and she's buried that into the net. One more serve to come. And this is one of those big points that crop up in matches. And it's into the net again. It's game point to Ligi to take what would be her third game in a row, having trailed 2-0. Yeah. You have to attack it. It's still game point. Back into the table, and that's brought the point. It's two game points which have been saved. It's 10 all, and now it's alternate serves, a lead of 2 points required. The third game in this match was extended. That went on to 16-14 before finally being won by Li Ji. Still two games all, 10 all. Third time, game point to Li Ji of the Netherlands. What a point, what a way to win it. Just clipping the almost the outside edge of the table, but it still counts. And so it's advantage the Netherlands now, who lead in this women's singles third round match by 3-2, and it's turned around completely. Natalia Partyka winning the first two games, 13-11, 11-6. And Li Ji coming back strongly to win the third, 16-14, 11-7 in the fourth, and now 12-10 in the fifth. Li Ji seeded in this Olympic competition at 14. Her world ranking currently at 28, still only 18 years of age, born in Sichuan in China. Finished in third place in the ITTF Professional Tour Grand Finals in the women's doubles. But she must have sown now more than a seed of doubt in the mind of Natalia Partyka. Natalia Partyka of Poland to serve at the start of the sixth game, having led by 2-0. We've seen her opponent claw her way back into this match to now lead 3-2. Teasing with each other, trying to draw a mistake from the opponent. Long. So both players have won one, lost one on their opening serving sequence, 2-2. Both those points dropped. Well, it will be a bitter defeat for Partyka if she were to lose this third round match, having led 2-0. She was ahead in the third game as well, led 8-6 before finally losing at 16-14. All right, bounced on her own side of the table. Patient rally. Well, the last 4 points have all been won against the serve. It's getting tense. Oh, that's a wild one. Both players there losing the 2 points on their serving sequence. And if you pick the right ball to attack, we've had 10 points in this 6 game and only 2 of them have been won by the player who has served. Bit of daylight beginning to open up between them. Both players mixing it up, trying to draw a mistake. Change of serve. It was too high. Too much height. Li Ji putting it away gleefully. Now leading by 3 points. Didn't quite float that one back the whole distance, dropped short. still the Netherlands with the advantage of 2 points, and their player Li Ji with two serves. And that's gone long. And that now gives game point. It's match point, 10-6, to complete a remarkable fight back. Well, is that the third time, I think, that she's had a lucky net contact? Still three more match points to save. And just take them one at a time. And for the second time of asking, the match point is won, 11-7 in the sixth game to complete that comeback. Having trailed by 2 games to love, Li Ji, 18 years of age, seeded at 14 in the women's competition, ranked 28 in the world, having to dig deep to get herself back into the match and win that third game, 16-14, but from then on was able to continue and close out the match by 4-2. There's a reminder of the score. First 2 games going to Natalia Partyka of Poland. But Li Ji winning 16-14, 11-7, 12-10 and 11-7 in the sixth to claim her place in the fourth round of the women's singles tournament. A place in the round of the last 16.